Start.
Yeah.
Good evening, everyone. Today we have the speaker Pradeep. So he has graduated from RGUKT in 2014, and he did his bachelor's in metallurgical and materials engineering. After completing his master's in India, he went to Japan, and then completed his PhD. And I would say, to my knowledge, he's the first student to get PhD degree from all the RGUKT students. And I think he's the first student who did his degree in abroad as well. After completion of his PhD, he has joined in Suzuki Motors, and now he's working there. So Pradeep, we are privileged to listen from you. And now the occasion is yours, please.
So thank you, Mohan, for introducing, and I mean, thank you for your kind introduction, few lines. Yeah, so first of all, let me thank the Change Rural India NGO. Like, I mean, they have spent their valuable time, to initiate such an initiation is really appreciable. And my heartfelt wishes to them, and I wish that we will... So I wish like we should go in the right direction by guiding guiding our juniors, and then like probably we can extend, you know, like the Pan India topic. So yeah, so to let me all welcome you to today's session. It is like what after MME, just a second. So MME, like what is MME? Like anyway, like I'm just saying MME, that is like metallurgical and materials engineering. And by the way, this MME actually, the definition of this MME actually varies depending upon the country and depending upon the nation. That is like, you know, some people say like just material science and metallurgical engineering, and some people just say like material science engineering. Some people just say like just metallurgical engineering. We were like the metallurgical engineering in this MME thing is just introduced in RGUKT. That's just because, you know, since we were the first batch, and I still remember the discussion between the vice chancellor of RGUKT and then the faculty. Like, I mean, what is this thing like materials and metallurgical? If you do not put in India metallurgical, the industries really are not so interested in you, because in India, the scope for material scientist is not so high. And that was the opinion that I had even when I was pursuing my master's in IIT Hyderabad. So however, like when I came to pursue like doctoral course in Osaka University, Japan, I have realized the importance or the significance that a material scientist have in most of the industries, and not just in industries, all over the fields. I mean, it is so significant that I was so shocked. The level that they treat a material scientist or metallurgist in India, and the level they treat in Japan or any foreign education system or industry, that really shocked me. And then I realized, okay, I mean, I took material science or metallurgical engineering as my first choice, by choice, not by force though. But I was so happy after coming here that I made a great decision by choosing metallurgical and materials engineering. But yeah, let me, you know, like every time saying this metallurgical and materials engineering is quite uncomfortable. So let me just say, like, from now onwards, like a material scientist, because when you come abroad or probably when you start working, you will really realize how important a material scientist for an industry or, you know, for this world. So like for today, I would like to cover on this thing, like, you know, what after MME? This question we had when we joined this degree, when I think in 2011, I'm not wrong, yes, 2011, when we joined this MME, like most of my batchmates, they couldn't get their first option, and then like they were forced to take this degree. So that time, like, you know, most of many faculty, they tried to motivate the people, like, you know, you have those many opportunities, you have this, you have that. But like, we still, you know, weren't so motivated to continue in MME. So for today, like, I would like to give the glimpse of it. Like, I mean, what can you do after MME? What are the opportunities that you'll be having? And then, like, I would like to show some of your seniors or my batchmates' profiles. I mean, how had they constructed their career from nowhere without any guidance? And how hard they worked? Like, I would like to show, you those things. So just spend some time with me. I hope like this would be very this would be very helpful for you to build your career. So before going into like, I mean, before, so okay, yeah. So in a slide, if I just have to put like MME in a nutshell, like what are the opportunities or where can we work and what, how can we choose our career? So like this is metallurgical and materials engineering. I have put several majors. One is like, you know, automotive industry. So guys, like automotive industry, like when I was in my bachelor's, I used to think like, can I get into an automotive industry? I mean, even if I get, what should I do over there? Like I had this question. And fortunately, like I'm working in the automotive industry, that is automotive industry, that is, you know, Suzuki Motor Corporation, Japan. So I realized, like, I mean, what is my role in developing a new car, or like, how can I helpful to an industry? So in automotive industry, guys, I think if you are quite aware that, you know, the global warming issues, so we just have to reduce the fuel consumption, the gasoline products or petroleum products or diesel. So there is this concept of electrical cars, etc., etc. So how can you reduce the fuel consumption? The simple and the best solution is like reduce the car weight. If you reduce the car weight, obviously the fuel consumption comes down, and then like, you know, you can like directly or indirectly contribute to global warming issue. So how can you reduce the car weight? Is it like just a mechanical engineer? Can he do that by his design thing? No, I don't think, because these things, the weight reduction can only be dealt by the material scientist. I mean, he has to develop some new materials which has low density and low strength at the same, low density and low weight at the same time, high strength. So usually most of the cars, they are made up of various grades of steels. But if you can replace the steel with aluminium, how is that thought? I think if you are aware of the material properties, at least the density and then the weight, probably you are aware that, you know, aluminium is having lower density than steel. So if you can replace aluminium with steel, so the problem is solved. However, it is not so simple, because just replacing aluminium with steel is not sufficient, because aluminium is not having a higher strength like steel. So the combination, I mean, the what you can do is like you can actually design in a way like where you can use steel and aluminium together. So how will you design the welding? So welding, just by doing some arc welding or simple arc welding, can you weld the aluminium steel together? No, you cannot, because there are several metallurgical factors that you have to consider. For that, you need a material scientist, I mean, who has a vast knowledge in the material science field. I mean, the microstructure thing, like when you join aluminium and steel, like what are the problems that you will be getting and what are the challenges that you have to face and how can you approach that solution? So an automotive industry have all these such challenges, and not just metal. Like, why don't we consider polymers? Polymers are, you know, so light and then so cheap. Why don't you just replace, not so cheap though, but yeah, cheap. Why don't we replace with polymers? In that way, like, you know, when the polymers and ceramic industry, it has a lot of future, because developing new polymers or ceramics would obviously help the industry. At the same time, it will be having a broad career or broad future. So for that, I mean, like when I was in my bachelor's, like I used to study the steel making or iron making or the manufacturing, etc., etc., so deeply, the mechanical metallurgy or physical metallurgy. But I wasn't so conscious, I wasn't so careful to learn about polymers and then ceramics. Now I regret for that decision, because after joining Suzuki Motor Corporation, I realized the polymers and ceramics are so necessary, and the development of new polymers and ceramics are so important for a new car design. And that way, like, you can choose your career in polymers or ceramic industry. And the third next thing is biomaterials. Probably if only the Arjuket Inujvid students are listening, probably they can get the example that I will be saying. You might have been heard this example from one of our faculties, that is, when people's bones are broken, so you have to replace with some metal so that it can just recover, and then later you can just remove that metal away. So to fit that metal, can you fit any metal in the place of broken bone? No, you cannot, because you have to see the bone's Young's modulus and then the strength, and you have to put some material which has the equal or at least the near the similar strength and the Young's modulus. So there also the necessity of a material scientist or metallurgist comes. And the next thing is extractive metal making industry. This is where pure metallurgist, then important, or they really need a pure metallurgist, because this everything deals with making a metal from the ore. So I think we in metal, the metallurgy completely deals with making metal. So the steel industry, steel making or aluminium making, all these things, and they need the metallurgist. Like if I'm not wrong, I think our faculty, they have encouraged us, since there are less number of metallurgists, that's why the steel industry, they are taking the mechanical engineers, and then they are replacing instead of you. But however, if we have enough number of metallurgists who are capable, who are who has good knowledge, then obviously you can replace the mechanical engineer. Let me talk about this mechanical engineering thing, because they are the real competitors of metallurgical engineers or material scientists. Because let me talk about this manufacturing industry, because the mechanical engineers, probably people call them as universal engineers, because they can replace anyone and everywhere. So you have to be very strong and you have to be very specific in your skills if at all you want to be a replacement for a mechanical engineer. So this manufacturing industry, usually they need a mechanical engineer, because they have to design how a process should go and what is the final shape and what are the residual stresses that will be generating. So to deal with all these things, they need a mechanical engineer. But let me tell you this, there is this thing heat treatment. So a mechanical engineer, let me just put away that thing of mechanical engineer, because I already told about them. But a metallurgist, what can he do in a manufacturing industry? To get a shape that you want from nowhere, you use some cold working or hot working thing to get a final shape. So you just press so hard that the initial material shape, and then you will get a final shape. So you are inducing a lot of residual stresses. So usually this manufacturing industry, they actually do heat treatment. I think you might be aware of this this term called heat treatment, even the mechanical engineer. So if you ask a mechanical engineer, what will he say? Why do we do a heat treatment? He will probably, if we know in detail, probably he would say to remove the residual stresses that were generated during cold working or hot working. But is it just that simple? No, a metallurgist or material scientist, he know that doing a heat treatment can actually get rid of the residual stresses. At the same time, it changes the microstructure. That's how it changes the properties, or it gives the desired properties. Let me put an example, the martensite thing. Probably people might have heard of this term called Martin site, which is quite familiar in steel industry, which is very hard, which is having high strength, however, which is very brittle. So you, by doing this cold working, by cold working, you'll be getting this martensite phase. However, you cannot use it directly in the application because it is very hard and it can be easily broken. So to do, we do a heat treatment called tempering to use that in the applications. So that is what you can do in manufacturing industry. And then the second and the next thing is semiconductor industry. So what can you do in semiconductor industry? Like, you know, most of the EV people or electrical engineers, they, you know, they have this major in semiconductors. So in semiconductors, probably you might be aware of this, the term called band gap. So to get the certain band gap and the certain, I mean, the required properties in semiconductors, so we usually do this single crystal thing. So how can you, to get the single crystals, it is not so easy. So there are several techniques to get that single crystal thing, like the solidification thing. So for that also, you need a material scientist knowledge in semiconductor industry. So by putting away all these things, let me just put, like, if you are so good at mathematics, and if you have knowledge in material science and metallurgy, then you have a broad future. Let me just emphasize this, because most of the industries, I mean, the computational thing is now taking over all the experimental thing, because they need everything within fraction of time, most of the industries or the experiments. So if you have the combination of the material science knowledge as well as the computational knowledge, then you will be a hot product. Probably, you know, everyone want, like, I want this, I want that. In the sense, like, you will be so famous in your field. So this is what, I mean, MME or a material scientist can do in his career, in his future, if he has a degree for material science. So let me continue. So guys, like, you know, I have, when I was thinking, like, how can I guide you guys, like, you know, you do that, or you choose this path, or you choose that path, it will be so confusing, isn't it? But instead of that, I thought of, you know, by asking my friends, like, they recommended me, like, why don't we put some examples of our seniors or juniors who has constructed their career successfully, or else I shouldn't use successfully, because it will be like, you know, whomsoever people that I have included, it will be like, the conclusion would be they are the only people who are succeed. It's not true, but I'm just, you know, showcasing you some careers of my seniors or juniors that always inspires me, like, it's a motivation whenever I see. So like, I have asked from my contacts, like, you know, please, like, I asked them few questions, like, what was your opinion, what was your thoughts just after graduation, and then how did you proceed, and what were the steps that you followed, and how are you feeling now? So I asked them these four questions, and then I requested them to put a photo, and then, like, I asked them if they could give me, you know, their contact details, such as Gmail or Gmail or phone number. That would be really helpful for our juniors to contact them. So I really, really thankful for all those who responded in time, and who put their valuable time to prepare this. I'm really sorry, although whatever the information that you have sent me, I had just I have just put all of them into one slide, and I'm really sorry about that. But yeah, probably I will try to share all the information that you have given me in a separate email. While I was reading their stories, or while I was reading how have they constructed their careers, so, like, I found some naughty smiley, you know, like, that fits to their career paths. I just put that smiley at the right hand side. Probably you can just, you know, correlate. This is just, you know, a naughty thought that I got. So, yeah. let me get in detail like how like each of some of my seniors like how have they constructed their career. I'm really sorry, let me drink some water. He is Mr. Ganesh Pilla. He was one of my favorite junior. So just after graduation, probably you can see like I have decided to go to masters, and then like he cracked IIT. I mean, he cracked GATE exam, and then he joined IIT. I mean, if you see his thing, if you see his thoughts, like I mean, he has a clear idea that like you know he would like to go for masters. I mean, he would like to go for higher education, and he was unlike some of us, where like we were completely clueless. What should we do further? And let me come into that examples later. But yeah, for now he is Mr. Ganesh Pilla. And since he was so determined that like he would like to go for masters, so he cracked GATE with his preparation, and then like he pursued like his masters from IIT BHU in extractive metallurgy. And when he was pursuing his master, like in the final year, he got placed in Mahindra and Mahindra, and then he worked there for 2 years. And later he got shifted to work elemental material technology at Abu Dhabi, United Arab Emirates. So that is so, I mean, like, I'm so happy for you, brother. So probably this is one thing, like you can aim for higher studies, you can crack GATE, and then you can get into IITs, and then you can be placed. Let me tell you, like, why am I so emphasizing about this thing, like, you know, IITs? IITs are like one of the oldest institutes of our country, India. And they're most prestigious institutions. So even if you say about IIT in Japan, like people, oh, you're from IIT. So you should be very intelligent. But yeah, so let's put that away, like, you know, the IIT things. The reason why IITs are so strong or so famous, because they have very strong alumni and they have very long history. So their seniors were succeed in creating a positive impact in the all over the world, as well as in all over the industrial sectors. And that's the reason why if an industry have to take someone, then they would obviously select someone from a brand. That is where this thing called, you know, iPhone or branded things. It's not that the branded things are the only valuable thing. But yeah, you cannot avoid that branding thing, because obviously when you want to select a product, we'll obviously choose some product which is known to you and which is reliable, which you believe that it is reliable. And that's the reason why I recommend, like, yeah, GATE is the thing that you, if at all you want to have a better career, just prepare for GATE. If you prepare by yourself, it is not that hard to crack it. And the next profile is like Mr. Harish Adigilli. So he is like my batchmate. And just after graduation, probably you can see like he wanted to do PhD, and then he want to work on some exciting research topics in one of the Indian strategic organizations, like, you know, DRDO, ISRO, or BARC. So he's also one of that guy who has, you know, motivation or aim and what he want to become in future. And accordingly, he followed. He actually tried to apply in DRDO or ISRO, and then like he tried to search for positions in this DRDO at BARC or ISRO, and then like he got a JRF position at ARCI Hyderabad. And while he was working there as a JRF, he actually joined in NIT Warangal. Like, you know, you have this collaboration with ARCI or DRDO. Even IIT Hyderabad have such thing, like, you know, although you are a research fellow, but you can do your PhD by collaborating with one of the professor at IIT Hyderabad. And that is what he is doing. I mean, he has approached his goal in a different way. Usually people think, you know, crack GATE and then go take masters and then like you go for PhD there. But he took a different approach. That's all you could learn from his profile. And the next is like Mr. Hari Babu, like he was my junior as well as he was my junior even at IIT Hyderabad. So like he, you could see like we didn't have placements during my BTech final year 2015. So he was very much disappointed, it seems to be, because he wanted to go for a job desperately, but he couldn't get. So the only option left was pursuing higher education. So he prepared for GATE and then he cracked GATE. And he got admission in IIT Hyderabad and he pursued masters in IIT Hyderabad. And later he got, when he was at IIT Hyderabad, he published a lot of journal papers, like I think two or three in powder metallurgy. And then he joined in NFTDC as a project manager. Let me tell you, like, you know, material science or metallurgy, or so material scientists in India, they are very less paid. You need a lot of experience to be paid high. So really do not compare yourself with IT people because they have a lot of demand in India. So that's the reason why they get paid very high. But just do not disappoint yourself just by looking at that pay scale. Once you get experience, like, you know, 2 years or 3 years, then you will be treated very good and then you will be having very good salary. And then, like, after working at NFTDC, he has familiarized with many, like, you know, characterization techniques such as UTM or ICP or gas analyzer, XRD or SEM. And then now he is working as assistant manager at Mitanni Hyderabad, which is really nice. I mean, which is a nice strategic step to construct your career. And the next is Mr. S. Hari Babu. This guy is so inspiring to any one of us because probably I will share you his, what did he write? I was inspiring, man. Like I should say hats off to this guy because just after graduation, actually he has a lot of dreams and dreamt of becoming part of something big and challenging. It wasn't specific, but he has a big and challenge. I mean, he wants to do something challenging and big, which can satisfy his thoughts. So if you see his career, not just his dreams are big, but whatever he had done was something tremendous and remarkable. So he has cracked GATE because he wanted to do some research-oriented career. And his GATE rank was, you know, All India 21. And he didn't take any coaching. It was all his self-preparation. And he appeared for, you know, BARC interview. Like, he selected for BARC and did 1 year training at BARC Mumbai. And he received a Homi Bhabha medal during that training period. And then he joined at IGCAR Kalpakkam as a scientific officer C. So, like, you could see like how determined or how goal oriented is he. So you can also be like him. I think if I'm not wrong by the observation that I have seen, like he used to read a lot of books, and then at the same time he's, you know, multi talented. Like he has he used to conduct many events for our seniors. So he is an inspiration to any one of us. And next is Mr. A.V. Shabarinath. So he's my batchmate. He's the most entertaining person. So I got a platform to share about this guy. So, like, I mean, probably if you read about this guy. So just after graduation, he was saying, like, I was not having an idea how to look for opportunities. Because if you see, like, he wasn't chosen. I mean, he didn't choose metallurgy as material science as his first choice. So he wasn't known, as we do not have seniors. So we do not know how to even look for opportunities. And he had written GATE twice and he couldn't pass through. So I appreciate your honesty, brother. Yeah. He was always wanted to go into computer science field, but yeah, he couldn't get that opportunity. But he didn't give up, my friends. So since he was always fascinated about programming or IT domain, so he decided to choose in a different path. So there is nothing wrong. So for that, like, he took Java and then .NET framework courses for an year. And then, like, he did job hunting and then he worked in a startup for 3 years. I do not know about the salary, but it should be, you know, since it is a startup. So we shouldn't think about the salary now. So now he's working as a senior associate consultant in Infosys Bangalore. So I was so surprised by seeing, you know, how is he feeling now? He said, like, you know, design two mobile applications for a chemical plant and for a petroleum plant. So he said, like, you know, if I'm not from a material science background, then it would have been a nightmare for me to design such applications. So it is not waste that you have done MME and you choose a computer science department. If you had heard, like, yesterday's Mr. Falgun's webinar, he had said that there is this thing, business analyst and then prototype designer. So there comes, like, you can actually portray yourself that, you know, we can serve industries even in that sector. And with the knowledge that you have, you can design some codes and then you can be a valuable product or you can be a valuable employee to your industry. So next, she's Penku Sukanya, one of the, like, I have put, like, two girls' profiles to motivate you. And she's like my little sister, like, she's so active. And you can see, like, I was so keen to go for a job in relevant field. However, I was unable to get one, hence I decided to go for higher education. So she tried for job, but according to her, you know, family conditions, but she couldn't get a job. However, then, like, she worked as a lecturer in a private engineering college at mechanical engineering department. But she didn't give up on her dreams, friends. Like, she had cracked GATE and then she pursued her master's at IIT BHU. And she said, like, it was her dream to get an IIT degree. And then she placed in a Tata Steels. And now he is working at Tata Steel. And you can see how big she is dreaming, that she is thinking to choose a career in MBA. So I appreciate you. So even girls, like, I mean, do not think, since we are a material scientist or, like, metallurgy, so it is very difficult for us to get a job. No, it's not true. You also have a lot of career opportunities. You just have to work hard and then work hard on your dreams. Next guy is, like, Suresh Bandi. So just after graduation, he was so keen to go for a job in relevant field, but however, he was unable to get one. So he just decided to go for higher education. So just by reading this sentence, it seems to be he wasn't so interested to do what he want. But, like, you know, I was so shocked by seeing his profile yesterday or day before yesterday, because if you are aware of this scripta material and then octa materia, these are very high impact factor journals and it is very difficult to publish in such journal papers. So he cracked PGCET and then he did his master's from Andhra University and he is pursuing his PhD from NIT Nagpur. While doing that PhD, he has actually published several research papers in scripta materia and then, like, many LGBA journals. So it is so inspiring. I mean, so although it seems to be he was not goal-oriented, he doesn't have much motivation, but he built up that motivation and he didn't give up on his life. He just wanted to achieve something, and that's the reason why he is doing something tremendous in the research field that he has chosen. Brother, I wish you good luck. And next is Mr. Imani Pawan Kumar. So since, like, it's been reading, so probably you might be boring, but yeah, let me just be fast on these things. Like, you know, just after graduation, his thoughts were, like, you know, since he was forced to choose metallurgy, so he wasn't at all passionate about his field of study. So, however, like, he is also having interest in RDBMS and programming constructs. So he has learned Oracle or Shell scripting, .NET and Java courses. And then he did job hunting and then he started working in a startup. And now he's working in Adatran Networks as a senior software engineer, the term called, you know, senior software engineer for a guy whose major is, you know, material science and metallurgy, which is something, you know, funny, but it is not funny. He has done a lot of hard work to choose to be in a position in like that. So you can also choose in this way. You can also choose your career in that way. And next, she is Konki Pramila. So she actually wrote, I really appreciate this girl's effort. She is my batchmate. She said, like, you know, frankly, no clue, neither qualified for GATE nor secured any job. So simply I was confused and clueless. So what did she do? Because she wasn't having any seniors like you have now, although I do not know how much helpful we are for you, but yeah, at least for namesake, or else you know, we are they. But since we were the first batch, we do not know anyone, and even for faculty, it was very difficult to guide each one of us because we were 250 people. So what she did was so remarkable that she searched for all the metallurgy based companies by herself, and then she approached them via emails. Like, she wrote each company by preparing a CV, and then she's interested to work with them. And then she got an interview call from Innomate Powders Hyderabad, and she joined, she cleared the interview, and then she joined as a technical trainee at Innomate Powders, and later she promoted to junior engineer in quality control section, and now she is pursuing a sponsored master's degree from Andhra University. See, friends, I mean, it is for a girl to put so much efforts. Since she is a girl, so probably she could have chosen software industry or probably some management thing. But she was so passionate about her field, and she would like to use her knowledge. So she has done her homework. That means, like, you know, she didn't depend on anyone. Rather, she has searched everything by herself, and then she wrote, I think, I do not know how many mails she might have written. So, and her hard work is now paying her by getting you know, sponsored masters, and hope she will achieve whatever she wants in her career. So, and the final profile that I would like to show is, like, for today is Tataji Maicharla. So yeah, he was also, like, since he's saying, like, he said, like, his family had supported him very well to pursue his master's. So he has choose, he wanted to choose a like, you know, research oriented career, and that's the reason why he cracked gate, and then, like, he joined in NIT Trichy, and then he got placed in a UAE, he got placed in Dubai as a quality engineer, and, like, after 2.5 years of experience, then he got he joined in SAIL as an assistant manager. So these are all, you know, like, several things. These are all the several ways that you can actually construct your career. You can actually choose, and of course, not just these are not just limited, but I have just put, you know, some examples where you can actually take them, and then you probably can take them as a reference, and then you can actually construct a beautiful career in metallurgical and materials engineering. So for me, like, since I excluded my introduction at the beginning because I just wanted to put my profile as also as one of an example. So my probably you might have heard, like, I'm Pradeep Kumar Parchuri. I'm from a background, like, where in my village, or, like, at least in my family, like, there was no one who has some bachelor's degree hold. There was not any bachelor's degree holder. So I just wanted to pursue something highest that is possible in my career. And that's the reason why I always had a thought of, you know, pursuing PhD. But at the same time, I always have this, you know, I would like to work in some industry to solve some real-time problems. So I was always, you know, confused between these thoughts. So since I didn't get any placements, however, I cracked gate. So I got an opportunity to work at IIT, to pursue my master's at IIT Hyderabad. Although, like, to mention, like, I missed an opportunity to study at IIT Kharagpur. However, I was so sad that time, but I do not regret for what have happened, because for whatever I am now, so that is what happened, that I could miss the opportunity at IIT Kharagpur, but I got an opportunity at IIT Hyderabad, and that's the reason why I could get a scholarship from Japan, and then I could get a PhD. I mean, I could get an opportunity to pursue my PhD studies at, you know, Osaka University, Japan. So that's the reason why I pursued my doctoral course. And since it was always there in my mind that, you know, I just would like to contribute something in the industries, that by working on real-time problems, because I'll be more motivated if I work on real-time problems. I mean, whatever I'm developing now, if I see them happening in front of me, for example, if I design a new material, and if the same material is being used in the car, that will be so self-satisfied. That is what I'm looking for. And that's the reason why I have chosen my career to work in industries, and I would like to teach students also. Probably I will just think of choosing a career in teaching probably after some time, but at least my focus is just on, you know, work on something innovative that gives so much satisfaction for me. So probably I can just tell you that, you know, stand on your decisions by taking the responsibility. So I took my metallurgical and materials engineering as my first choice. So my parents weren't happy for that. They scolded me because they do not know the value of material science. Even like to pursue master's or PhD, they weren't so much willing. But I convinced them because it was my decision and I took the responsibility for what I chose. And although they weren't satisfied for a few months, but later they were so happy, and now they are proud of me, probably, I hope. So that's I'm so happy for whatever I'm now. Before going into that, like in a slide, just after graduation, so the easy thing that you could do is like, you know, crack GATE. So you can actually do that if you listen or if you work little hard, then it is not so easy to crack GATE. So you can go for higher education, and after higher education, like at IITs, you can actually choose your career in industries, or you can go for PhD, and or else like you can actually choose as like Pramila and then like Harish did, like, you know, they searched for JRF positions or a core job by themselves by putting a lot of efforts, and then they got some job in a core field, and then later like by gaining experience, now they are in a good position. Or else, if you are not satisfied or if you do not want all these things at all, then you can actually prepare yourself like Mr. Shabrinath and Pawan Kumar did. So they have prepared themselves, and then like they choose their career in software industry. So there is nothing wrong. So even after even if you are a metallurgist, you have lots and lots of opportunities in IT or software jobs, because this IT or software jobs also need a metallurgist or material scientist knowledge. So these are all some messages from your seniors. Probably I will not read all these things because you'll be feeling so bored probably. So, but since I will be sharing all these presentations to you, you can actually go through them and then you can actually take their suggestions. I have highlighted few things or few, you know, key words in each of your seniors' messages. That is like, you know, planning, be focused, be strong in your fundamentals, and then like just choose the right thing, what is good for you or what you are good at. And then like hard work and smart thinking, and be honest and good attitude. And especially, yeah, these are all the things when you are constructing or when you're planning your career, you have to be so specific. My friends, let me emphasize this thing, because you have, you know, I have shown you a lot of profiles where people are in a good positions. They are very much well settled. But yeah, so to do that thing, it is not so easy, especially if you are from material science and metallurgy background, because we do not have opportunities like, you know, computer science or an EC or mechanical engineer have, at least in India. The scenario is different in foreign countries, but at least if you want to have a career in India, so you just at least have to work hard for at least 1 year, you know, like, you know, cracking GATE, which will widen your opportunities or which will open a lot of doors for you to choose your career vivid and then brightful, or to be in a position to have self-satisfaction and then make yourself proud. So it is not so easy. I wouldn't say that, you know, it is like a cakewalk for you to get a job or to choose a career in material science or metallurgy, at least in India. You have to be very focused and then goal-oriented, or at least never give up. This thing should be there, because if you give up, then there ends your career. So never ever give up whatever the field that you choose. To end this presentation in a good note, like, you know, probably you might have heard this, you know, Sundar Pichai, so he's CEO of Google. Take career in metallurgy from IIT Stanford, and he did his master's from Stanford University, and later he pursued his MBA, and then now he's Google CEO. So probably by seeing his career, and then like by seeing my friends or mine, all our careers, or you know, the way we constructed our careers, like I probably, I do not know, someone might have quoted this already, or nobody said, like, you know, nothing and no one can stop you for what you want to become if you have a strong will and if your efforts are honest. So if you are good at this thing, then you can achieve something. It may be late, but it will come someday, that will make your life or your career, when you just look back at your career, you will be so satisfied. Just believe me, because we are experiencing it now. Although we are young, I mean, it is very fast to say that, you know, when we look back, like, you know, you're so satisfied. Probably this would be said by some 50 years or 60 years old, or, you know, a Nobel laureate. But yeah, I'm just telling you from the background where we have come from, you know, from nowhere, like we have constructed or we have created the path for ourselves, and we worked hard, and that's the reason why where we are. And I believe and I hope you will be also like this, or in a much better position to guide your juniors or to your family members or your, you know, relatives in a better path. Yeah, so just before ending, I just wanted to, you know, tell this. But yeah, I forgot to tell, like, yeah, you know, since this is COVID-19 in India, like, you know, there are a lot of cases are coming. So I please ask, please take the responsibility to spread this COVID-19. Just be cautious. And I salute from this presentation, from the team of CRI, I salute all the medical workers, or this, I know, the people who are working very hard by affording their lives to save a lot of people's lives. So yeah, with this note, I will end this session, and then please subscribe to our channel CRI on Facebook or YouTube, on Instagram, and please follow us. And dear juniors, I would like to emphasize one thing, that, you know, this is just beginning, where our alumni, I mean, if you see IIT people, I mean, IIT graduates, they have very strong alumni. And that's the reason why their placements, or else their career, they have very good career. So since it is our responsibility as an alumni to build, to spread the positivity, to get a positive impact about RGKTs, it is our responsibility. So I hope this CRI will take this forward on a positive note, and I hope I request those whoever participating in this webinar, so please put your hands, and let's put all our hands together to make our alumni stronger, and then let's make something innovative which can give a positive opinion or a strong impact about RGKTs in the industry, in all over the India as well as all over the world. Thank you.